First look at Descendant X ROM based on Android 10 running on the Redmi K20 Pro. Hey peeps, what's up? Manji here, back with another video. And in this video, we're going to have our first look at the Descendant X ROM based on Android 10 running on the Redmi K20 Pro. Now, in terms of UI, this ROM is at a completely different level. If you are bored of the same UI, same graphic styles, then trust me, Descendant X will be a refreshing change for you. We are going to start with the launcher, which is baked in. And as you can see, we have launcher baked in, which means you have more controls over your gestures and you can add home screen gestures as well. This is how your quick settings look like. Have a look at that brightness slider. Dope, pretty cool, and looks amazing in my opinion. As for the different tiles which you get, here are the different quick setting tiles which you get with Descendant X ROM. And in case you want to add more, these are your different options for that as well. Next thing, let's have a look at the super cool volume panel. So let me press the volume rocker. Here it is on the side, hidden, swipe, expanded, click on this arrow and you get the different options. Have a look at those animations. They are smooth as butter. Another thing which I would like to mention is if you swipe down to get the quick setting tiles on the top right, you will notice that it is going to tell you how much time is left for your battery to run out. This is a feature which was added with Android 10, but it is not implemented in many custom ROMs. Next up, if you go into the settings panel, you will see that the dashboard conditions has a small button. Now, in most custom ROMs, if you do not finish your Pixel setup or your device's setup, you do get this big pop-up on the top. In Descendant X, you have a small notification about it. And if you want it expanded, you click on this. And if you don't want it expanded, you click on it again and you won't have the dashboard notification, which in my opinion looks pretty ugly. Next, if you have a look at the different options, they are in a different shade. So the options have a gray background and then normal is white background. We can now have a look at the different customization options which you get with Descendant X. First, we'll go into battery. As you can see, it does have battery saver and battery manager. You can also add your battery percentage using this toggle. And you also have Descendant's own idle manager, wherein they have their own algorithm to ensure that you get maximum efficiency out of your battery. And then we can move over to display. In display, this is your brightness level. Have a look at that slider. Pretty different and pretty refreshing on the eyes. You do have your dark theme in the building, adaptive brightness, wallpaper, and have a look at these icons beside the different options. So for screen timeout, you have a different icon which says ZZZ, which means to, you know, sleep. Other than that, you have the option of choosing the auto rotate angles. So you can choose between 0, 90, 180 and 270. Then you can choose between the colors, whether you want natural, boosted or adaptive. Next up, you can configure your font size, your display size. You can of course change your DPI as well. And for those of you who like one-handed use, they have a new toggle called Thumb UI. Once you enable this, the options will shift down, so it is easier for you to use the phone with one hand because all the options have now shifted down. This is very impressive feature which I feel, because in other devices which have one-handed mode, the screen shifts down. I mean, the whole UI shifts down and then you have a big ass ugly black bar on either side of the options. Nothing like that in Descendant X. Looks pretty dope and pretty professional. I mean, I have no two doubts in saying that this is something which Google should look into, considering the fact that phones are getting bigger and bigger day by day. Other than that, you also have double tap to wake in the building. And if you go into lock screen display, herein you can customize your ambient display and your always on display. So if you enable always on, then you have different options. So with always on, do you want a fingerprint animation? And then what are you looking for? Do you want like the always on like this with the normal fingerprint icon? Or if you want the always on with say only the fingerprint icon. So let's say show only fingerprint icon on always on display. So now it's only going to display the fingerprint icon. You do not have the clock and your notifications on the top. Again, very nice customization, and of course the fingerprint, as we all know, is not perfect on the Redmi K20 Pro or the Mi 90 Pro, so it is nothing against the ROM. Then if you do not want the fingerprint on the always on display, you have a toggle for that as well. And in this case, the fingerprint icon should disappear from the always on display. And as you can see, it is no longer there. Double tap to wake, working like a boss. Fingerprint not perfect, as I mentioned earlier, nothing you can do about that. Then you can also configure your ambient display to show up when you connect the device to the charger. If you want your screen to wake up for new notifications, ambient music ticker, go into advanced, and you can configure your pickup, raise to wake, and your always on. Next, if you go into lock screen, you can choose what all content you want to see on the lock screen. If you want to add a user from the lock screen, any lock screen message, I generally keep it as my emergency contact information. Then if you want to see the lock crown option on the lock screen, you have a toggle for that as well. And if you enable clock flow, then you have a different kind of always on display, which looks pretty dope as well. So here it is with the Descendant logo, and you have multiple options for this clock flow option which Descendant X has added. Then if you want ambient wake gesture and double tap to sleep anywhere on the lock screen, you have a toggle for that as well. And of course here it is, double tap to wake, double tap to sleep, working like a boss. Next up in display, we have theming. So you can change the accent color. You have a bunch of options including Ferrari red, and of course red is my favorite color, so I am using the Ferrari red option. Then you can change the headline and body font. These are your different options. Let's say we choose Noto Serif, and here it is, the headline font is different and the body font is different. You also have the option of changing the icon shape, so you can choose between device default, teardrop, square circle, and rounded rectangle. And if you go into the styles app, you have only one theme which is baked in, but of course you can add your own themes. If you go into clock, you have multiple clock options. So you have default, default bold, then you have the Samsung clock in the building, Samsung bold, you have bubble, then you have analog, and last but not the least, you have the all text clock as well, and all these options work absolutely fine. Next up, we'll go into sound and have a look at the customizations which you have over here. So you do have live caption working like a boss, and of course make sure when you install this ROM for the first time, you do update all the applications. Then you have toggles for dial pad tones and other different options. My favorite one is screenshot shutter sound, so a feature which I think all custom ROMs should eventually implement. Because even when you put your phone into silent mode and you take a screenshot, it does make a sound which is very irritating, and I'm not sure why putting my phone into silent or do not disturb mode makes that screenshot sound. Completely absurd, but you know, Descendant X has fixed that. Then you can control your music using the volume rockers. If you want to swap the volume rockers when the device is rotated in portrait or landscape, then remember the super cool volume panel? Well, if you want a button instead of, you know, swiping across like this to get it expanded, well, enable this option, and now when I open the volume panel, here's a small button, and bam, it is now expanded. And trust me, I am in love with these super cool features and animations which Descendant X has added. Another nifty feature is if you reduce the volume to minimum, it will pause the media if you enable this toggle, and then if you want to resume it, say after a specific amount of time, you have a toggle for that as well. And of course for the Redmi K20 Pro, they have baked in Mi Sound Enhancer along with the option to enable Hi-Fi. Next up in storage, they have Descendant Storage Manager, which works hand in hand with Android's default manager and it does free up some space if you want to. Nothing much to talk about in privacy and location. In security, you do have your fingerprint. You can set it up, but you do not have face unlock. And as you would know by now, that face unlock was removed by Google in Android 10. So nothing the custom ROMs can do about it until and unless somebody smart figures it out. Then we can go into system, and you do have the front camera effects. So if you want the visual effects, you have a toggle for that, wherein the front camera lights up when you open it. And you also have the sound effects to choose from. You can choose between these different options for your front camera pop-up. Then you go into gestures, and we have system navigation, three different kind of gestures. And if you click on the gear icon besides the full screen navigation, you have the option of adjusting the back button sensitivity. Other than that, you do have three finger screenshot in case you want to enable that. And those are the different options which you get with Descendant X. Going back into about phone, if I scroll all the way down, you will see that it is telling me the uptime, but another impressive feature is it tells me that my device was in deep sleep mode for almost 89% of the time. And last but not the least, have a look at this power off menu. Generally it is on the side, but trust me, I am super impressed with the UI changes which Descendant X has made, and I think Google should hire some of these developers and give them a chance to, you know, improve Android and the way it looks. I like the consistency, the smooth flowing gestures. Here it is. Have a look at the notification which I am getting. I can share, edit, and delete. They are in the center, making it much more of an elegant look. And before I forget, you also have Xiaomi's camera baked in, and in pro mode you will have the option for raw mode as well. So that is another added advantage of Descendant X on the Redmi K20 Pro. And as for the benchmark scores, here are the benchmark scores on your screen right now. And as I always say, benchmark scores are just numbers. Go ahead and enjoy the ROM. And that will do it for this video. Hope my video helped you. Likes, shares, and subscribes are appreciated. Feedback and comment more than welcome. See you when I see you.